can see, we are going through the session of solid liquid mixture, separation of solid liquid mixture, and we know that there are 6 methods in total. We have already completed 3 methods out of that, and today we are going to discuss centrifugation. So hello everyone, welcome to Akar chemistry classes. We are going through a series of session for the chapter Is Matter Around Us Pure, a class 9 chapter, and the session number is 25th. Already we have completed 24 sessions with many number of topics in it. So today our topic is centrifugation. Let us try to understand what is centrifugation. See, centrifugation is a process which is employed in some of the cases where you have to separate suspended particles from a liquid particle, suspended solid particles from a liquid particle. Generally this process is used in case of colloidal solutions. You can remember that we have, when we were discussing about colloidal solutions, we have gone through the mixture of cream and milk. We have gone through the mixture of water and milk, isn't it? We saw that milk was there and some suspended particles were floating in the water. Okay, so to separate cream from milk, we can use this process of centrifugation. Also, we can use where we want, in the cases of this machine, washing machines, you can see that in drying machines, what happens that water is squeezed out from the wet clothes. How it is done? It is all because of centrifugation. Okay, similarly in diagnostic labs also, urine and blood samples, they get separated out of each other, they get separated from each other all by the help of this centrifugation process. Okay, so these are a few examples where we use this centrifugation process. We use this method because it is a very fast method of separation. Generally we use filtration and crystallization for such type of methods, but here we are going to use this centrifugation. Okay, we'll try to understand what is this all about. Okay, so in this case what happens, that let us try to understand what actually is the process. Okay, what is this method? So centrifugation, is a process where suspended particles in a liquid. Okay, solid suspended particles in a liquid. Are allowed to whirl. Okay, allowed to whirl. Whirl is spinning. Okay, allowed to spin, you can say. Okay, allowed to spin at very high speed. At a very high speed. Okay. So what happens in centrifugation, that solid suspended particles in a liquid or in a mixture are allowed to whirl upon at a very high speed. Those particles are allowed to spin around. Okay, the spinning happens in the centrifugation process. And what is the principle behind it? What is the principle behind the centrifugation? The principle behind it is that when a very fine suspension is whirled upon, or you can say is spun upon, the heavier particles, okay, what happens that during whirling, okay, heavier particles are forced, okay, forced towards the bottom. Okay, the heavier particles are forced towards the bottom of the liquid and lighter particles stay at the top. Okay. So this is the principle. What principle? That when once the churning happens, when once the whirling happens, the rotation happens or spinning happens, the heavier particles, they start moving towards the bottom of the liquid, and the lighter particles, they start staying up. Okay, they move towards the up, or you can say that they get separated out of it on the surface. Okay. And how this happens, that when this happens, that actually the centrifuge is a machine where it is allowed to whirl. Okay, and in that case, pull in and pull out, there are two, there is one force which acts in this, and that is centrifugation force. Okay, and in that, what is what happens, that pull in and pull out type of pushes are occurring over there. Okay, and that allows the, that pushes the heavier particles downward. Okay, the force acts horizontally. Okay, the force acts horizontally, but then what happens, that if you are having whirling, the spinning is happening. Okay, and the force acts like this, outward force acts. Okay, so due to outward force, what happens, that happening at very high speed. So what happens, that heavier particles, they move generally, or you can say they slightly, they move down, and the lighter particles, they are staying at the top. Okay, so this is how the suspended heavier particles are removed out of the liquid. Okay, so in case of even the milk also, you can see that if milk is taken into a centrifuge or in a test tube, and with a pivot in lab centrifuge, if you are going to put that test tube, you will see that after shutting the lid, centrifuge will start rotating, start spinning. Okay, and the tube containing milk swings out in horizontal position. It will start swinging out in horizontal, like this. It will start swinging. Okay, and what will happen, that and it whirls around. Okay, its axis, like if this is the axis, so it will start spinning around this axis. It will start spinning around the axis like this. Okay, it will not start spinning upward downward. Okay, it will start horizontally. That is known as whirling. Okay, so around its axis and at very high speed. Okay, then there, what happens, that centrifugal pull pushes the heavier particles outside, and and due to which, when it pushes the heavier particles, you know that it is the property of heavy particles that it goes down. What happens, that it pushes the heavier particles outside. Okay, there is one spinning machine, and if you will see that there is a rod in it, and it starts rotating, and then it pushes the, due to centrifugation, or you can say that due to centrifugal force, the heavier particles are pushed towards the outside, and being heavy, they goes down, they get down to the bottom, and the lighter remains at the top. Understood? So this is all about centrifugation. What is there? Let us try to understand first this by one diagram. Say if you are having this, there is one machine, you can say it is known as centrifuge. It is known as centrifuge. The centrifugation occurs in this machine. Okay, so we call this machine as centrifuge. What is happening here, that four test tubes are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, four test tubes at a time are taken, and they are fixed on this centrifugal machine. Okay, this is a centrifuge, and there are lobbies made in it, and each one is attached to it, and what is filled into it, milk is taken, milk with cream with fat is, or you can say that milk with containing fat is taken into it, and in each of the tube you will put the milk. And what is happening, that once you are going to start rotating, or once you are going to start spinning, whirling, once the whirling starts, what will happen, that this will start at very high speed, this will start rotating at very high speed. Okay, it will start spinning at high speed, and then what will happen, it will start throwing its throwing the suspended, or you can say the heavier particles outside. It will start throwing heavier particles outside. You can see this in your where you can see If you want to see this process, you can do one thing more. You can take one, say you can take a glass, okay, and take one, take just milk into it, okay, very slow. I mean, since you are not going to, you will not be able to do centrifugation here. But yes, one thing you can understand out of it, that when you are going to take one one rod to stir it, okay, to stir this milk, and you can stir it like this, like this. What will you, what observation you will see, that the milk will start moving outward, okay, it will start moving outward, it will start it will start moving outward towards outside. It will not come nearer. It will start moving out. ऐसे ऐसे बाहर की तरफ वो भागेगा. वही चीज़ यहाँ पे होती है कि it will start moving outward. ये actual में यहाँ पे जो centrifugation, जो centrifugal force होता है वो इस पर act करता है. It starts acting on this and it throws the milk outside. Okay, it throws the milk outside and what happens due to that that force, the milk gets heavier and the suspended particles in the form of fat, it becomes lighter and it stays on the top and the rest of the milk goes down, or the heavier part goes down. Okay, so we can, in short, we can say that this is a centrifuge machine and it is used to separate solid suspended particles from a liquid. Okay, what else is there? If you, what happens in this, it swings in and swings out. Okay, it happen, what actually is happening into it, that it swings in and swings out and it spins at very high speed. Okay, and centrifugal force acts on the suspended particles. Okay, so what happens, that those which are heavier, they goes down and at the bottom, and the rest of the milk is and the rest of the fat, those which are lighter, they remain at the top surface. So this is how we used to separate these fat from the milk. Okay, so this is all completed. If you want to write in points, you can write also that what is there, what we are doing in it. The method states what, that if you take some cream milk, okay, let us write in steps. Take some cream milk, okay, take some cream milk, okay, and put in the centrifuge, put in centrifuge, ठीक है, then what happens, then shut the lid, okay, and start the machine. Okay, what will happen? The tube containing milk swings in and out. Okay, the tube starts swinging in and out. Okay, it starts swinging in and out, in and out. And where it swings it? In the horizontal position around its axis. Okay, so in and out in horizontal position, always remember horizontally, the force acts horizontally. Okay, so in horizontal position and whirls around the axis, or its axis, whirls around its axis at very high speed. Okay, if the speed is not higher, the separation will not be clear. Okay, then what happens, that the centrifugal pull starts acting on the heavier particle. Okay, heavier particles are pushed outward. Okay, and being heavy, they settle down. Being heavy, this settle down. they move towards bottom, move towards bottom. Okay, then what happens? And lighter particles, or the lighter particles remain at the surface. Lighter particles like fats, okay, cream or fats, okay, remain at the surface. Understood? So this is what all about centrifugation, and I hope now you have understood the use of centrifugation. Even in your washing machines, if you observe washing machines, while observation please be careful, that if you are going to observe washing machines, you can see that when you are going to, after stopping your machine, what you see, that when you are pulling out the when you go for the clothes to take out from the machine, what happens, that in the middle of the in the middle, this happen, this you can see in your I think semi washing machine, if you it will be more clear in semi washing machine. Okay, so in what happens is semi automatic. Okay, so what happens, that you will find that in the spinner the clothes, dry clothes are around the, okay, dry clothes are around your the tub. Okay, you will see, and it was all because this has thrown this, it acts horizontally, because all the clothes are lying outsider part, at in the outside part of the spinner. Okay, and in the middle it is empty all around. Okay, so this is this also works in centrifugation, also works in drying machines also. Okay, so with this we are completed with the centrifugation. We'll come up with another topic in the next session. Please, if you gain little thing or something from this session, or from the sessions which are going on, do subscribe the channel so that you can get another series also with some other topics, some other learnings. So go on watching, keep on watching. Till then, take care.